matter if you shout it or if you're in a mood. I'm begging you to come around. It doesn't matter if we judge, don't you sit around. Cause I was reminded we're nothing to hide. Don't know what I need to provide. I know you're never mine.
What's up? It's a new vlog in, Castle Falcon. They always say it's in mostly, but this is Borstal Heath, mate. But we're kicking off the vlog, Sugar Thieves headlining Castle Falcon. George Pannell joins me after his mercurial performance.
Thank you very much.
It's sick for you to be here because you weren't on the bill for a long time. You were like a last minute addition.
Wednesday.
So
2 days ago, yeah.
And the coolest thing is, like, I kind of know you from, you're usually like watching from the crowd and then on the stage invading. Yeah. But now you're getting to be on the stage, and I think that's like a sign of what's going down in our music scene. Like, it's so healthy that people like yourself are actually making the music as well.
Yeah, that's great. Yeah, it's just great to like be around because there's so many great bands, but being like playing with them, even to be like bottom of the bill, there's still like loads of people there come down early to watch.
Because I mean, your Sugar Thief, your Twitter profile picture, you've got a Sugar Thief t-shirt.
Yeah.
So clearly, like, this isn't just a random gig for you. Like, it must mean a lot to actually support
a
band you love.
I've seen them a few times.
Yeah.
A fair few times, so yeah, it's great.
Yeah. But I guess your music, George, you've got what's the song called?
Royal Affair,
which is kind of obviously influenced by Sugar Thief's Joy Affair.
Yeah, clearly.
You've got quite a Declan McHenry sound, and I thought that at the moment I heard you, and then you opened up your set with a cover of him, so clearly he's quite a big influence for you.
I think he was like the first guy that really made me want to play myself, because obviously I've been playing in my room and stuff, but I think it's different. Someone actually inspires you to get on stage, and because he was on his own at first as well, weren't he? So
I think for young people as well, like Declan's someone who just like resonates with them,
definitely.
Because he's speaking about issues
his lyrics aren't just generic.
Yeah, they're stories, man. Especially like Kids Don't Want to Come Home, and you look at kind of gender and sexuality and the way he approaches it. He just does. It's not like a murky territory when he does it.
Yeah,
it's just very honest. And when I look at young people, you're what, like 18?
Yeah.
So when I look at people your age, that's what it's like now, and it's really cool. It's not kind of like this big stigma, it's just kind of identity. And the cool thing that I notice about you and your mates when you go to gigs is you're always like jumping and moving, and I think there's you want to show up to the gig with bare minimum, no like heavy bag, like bottle of water, stay hydrated, just fucking like jump your mind out basically.
That's just fun, like.
Yeah.
And I think bands appreciate it as well. Like.
Oh, they do, man. Like Violet, you were in the pits in Violet, which is sick because you were supporting.
Because like, I think when you like play into a dead crowd, no one enjoys that, like.
Oh, no, it's the worst. Like.
Even just when people's heads are bobbing and like you can see people are into it.
I've been to gigs in other cities and, you know, I can see the vibe. It's not...
not as good.
We call it the Madlands for a reason. It's probably the cheesiest thing ever, but we still say it.
Who came up with that?
I think it was probably Jack Parker in an Ivory Wave popularised it. Blame George from Ivory Wave, it's usually what we do.
You do you want to join in?
Well, I'm not in the... I've played one gig.
You're in the band.
We're going to need to frame the show.
Yo, Violet, that was a sick gig. How's it going?
Yo!
Got Harry. We got Harry. Yeah. We got Luke. Yeah. We got... Yeah. You're not in, Violet.
I just played, though.
First of all, are you okay, Pat? Ted.
Again. Let's go.
No, keep it rolling.
Cut there.
Are you alright, Ted?
Yeah, I'm good.
Have you asked for a black cast so it matches your outfit?
Yeah, I mean, gotta stick to your stage.
So you can look good on stage.
Yeah. I was standing next to him and it was like a full on like sad MLG moment where he's looking at the stage like, I wish I was on there.
It was like that.
How did you?
He plays better than me anyway, so it doesn't matter.
But the style's not matching. The hair's not matching. That's
no, the hair doesn't match.
Yeah, that's it. I mean, if it wasn't for that, then he'd be in the band.
I'm not going to tell you.
What? I don't really know how to break this to you, but...
Harry's guy.
Whoa. We need a round of applause for that. Like, Harry's just come out. He's just come out live on the vlog. Congratulations.
Just for the record, I'm not, but...
That's not what's important. You just ruined it. Pride Month was... Is it Pride Month? I think it's Pride Month.
Every day is Pride Month.
Could you run us through, like, you know there's, like, animations for YouTube videos? So if you give me, like, an account of how you got injured, I can edit one. What happened to you, Ted?
Well, we were having a housewarming party because me and Patch just moved into a new place. We're Luke from Sugar Thief.
Yeah.
And everyone's been a bit too loud downstairs. Didn't want to piss off the neighbours. So ran downstairs with time shot up. And slipped, ran the worst way possible, ended up in hospital, and now I'm here.
Yeah.
That's it.
That's an exciting story.
It's not very exciting.
So was it Sugar Thief's fault then?
Yeah.
100%. Is it true that you dropped a single on the same day as their show to like as payback for that?
Absolutely ruined their day.
Ruined their day.
I mean, I can't comment, but...
Yeah.
Yeah, Luke from Violet says no comment, unfortunately.
The new single, Heaven Adores You, which the link will be in the bio, available through all good retailers, is out now. Dropped today, which is probably about 4 months ago by the time I've edited this video. So. You've made a visual for this, yeah. So there's a music video. Where you like drop some stones in a stream in slow motion to fit with the psychedelic. That's great. Yeah.
There's a better outtake of Ted in a river that never got used.
That's brilliant.
Did you float down the Liffey?
No, it will be used.
Do you want to turn this into Jeremy Kyle? Like, I've secretly hated my bandmates all along. What was the beef?
He used to go to cookery classes.
He did.
He went to one cookery class because his parents wanted to do extracurriculum.
Okay.
And he denies it. Endlessly since he came and told us at practice like 4 or 5 years ago.
So we're thinking a lot.
Honestly, to years.
Yeah,
Lloyd
you
want to take
I just want to say for the record, I've never been to a cookery lesson in my life.
Never.
You went to one.
He did.
I don't know how.
So wait. So if I asked you to make me a creme brulee, could you?
No. One lesson, which was an intro.
Ross from Echo Beach can make a creme brulee.
Oh, I love that.
I used to work in a kitchen.
Can I have a creme brulee?
Do you guys all hate Jamie Oliver as well?
Yes.
Why is he trying to ruin everyone's lives? Right, Jess.
Because he has this thing against sugar. I like sugar.
I like Sugar Thief.
Sugar Thief.
Jamie Oliver, he'd try and make Sugar Thief renamed to Salad Thief.
It's not how you say it, but how you move. It doesn't matter if you shout it. If you're in a mood, I'm begging you to come around. It doesn't matter if we just talk and sit around. Cause I was provided with nothing to hide. Don't know what I need to provide. I know you're never coming my way. And I'm gonna keep on trying.
Thank you. Hello. We're Sugar Thief. We're very happy to be here.
We're going to play an older song, which we haven't been playing recently. But why
why not? We were just telling Tim Senna about how this is when Geordie thought he was Jamie T. About being on the streets.
On the streets, boy.
That's famous.
Hello, Sugar Thief.
Hi.
How's it going?
Good.
Sick. Sick time.
Yeah.
Just been listening to that new Violet single.
Yeah, to
it's
be
not,
fair.
It's not bad, is it?
I've actually been listening to it all day, I'm not kidding.
On loop, on repeat?
Basically on repeat.
When I listen to Sugar Thief's music, I get a really kind of sense of, there's like a yearning almost to it, like a youthfulness. Do you think that's fair? Like,
I mean, I don't know, you think that, then...
Don't be all postmodern and bull... If you think I'm wrong, just say it, because I hate him.
Certain songs I'd say, yeah. Crying Youth is your youth.
Yeah?
I think, like, the impression I get... I remember when I was at school, I was always on the buses, and I think there's a lyric in Crying Youth which is like, don't try and intimidate me with your night... God, jeans.
Yeah.
Like, I remember, like, kids from the other school on the bus and...
Jamie T.
Yeah. Really?
And then I had everyone throwing Matthew's records at me out the windows of their cars after I put that song out. Because then they realised I was talking about them. So then we'd be walking down the street and they'd be like, alright.
Yeah. So, is it about that experience, like when you're walking when you're in school uniform, you get picked on sometimes by the kids in the other schools.
Yeah, it's kind of just, I think the thing of being like young and thinking stuff's a bigger deal than it is.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Whether it's like, no. You think everything's a big deal, but really it's not that, doesn't really matter, does it? So.
It's not that deep. Yeah. So go! Just leave! I ain't bothered that you're touching me. Can we talk about the new EP, the unreleased one? Because this is the thing. Jack was kind enough to send me a little link, so I listened to it.
You were not the only person.
What? Okay, yeah, I know. I'm not saying anything. Good luck. I felt
the
special.
EP now has almost 300 plays.
Yeah, it's not even out.
Unreleased. Everyone has been Jack sharing around the link.
Jack's leaked his own EP.
I leaked our own music.
I remember you had a dream once that you leaked your own single, but you're not even leaking it now. You're just sending it to everyone.
Yeah, that's not even a leak.
It's not public, but it may as well be at this point.
You've got a packet of nuts in there.
They match your soup on.
Bacon frizzles.
They're the best things ever. Frazzles. Right?
Bacon
frizzles.
Bacon fries. Have you seen the meme which is like God tier crisps and then tier crisps?
Oh, I don't even.
That's a controversial one. I think.
Don't even.
What crisps go on the God tier? What are we saying?
Doritos straight away.
Chili Heat Wave Doritos.
Yeah.
You can't. There is no other flavour on that one. Yo, man. Chili. Yeah. Do you want to join? I don't think we've met actually. Well, nice, Tim, nice to meet you, man.
I'm George.
George, nice to meet you, George.
She's Mysteries.
Are you in a band? No, Mysteries, big up. You guys don't even have social media, do you?
No.
That's sick. No, what sick, crisps man. Would you put on like the God tier? Have you seen a meme with the crisps?
On the God tier.
God tier crisps.
What's
that?
Might sound a bit weird,
but
cheese and onion myself.
Yeah.
McCoy's or Walker's?
Oof. Depends what mood I'm in. I'm a bit.
It varies.
Is this like the crisps you pick for like
eating.
If you're on
the best yeah, I don't know.
The crisps that you
love
the most.
Yeah, like the ones that kind of are worthy of worship if they're on the top tier, you know, you could form a religion around them.
McCoy's salt and vinegar are pretty nice.
Oh yeah.
Really
bacon frizzles. Sponsorship deal. What do you think like the main emotion associated with Sugar Thief is, if you can pin one down? I'll let Luke go.
Besides tinnitus.
Besides what?
Tinnitus.
Yeah.
That's an emotion, I think that's a problem. That's a hearing problem anyway.
That, yeah, I was gonna say
a medical issue that it comes from Sugar Thief.
I mean, I said the yearning. I think it's like
a yearn.
Joy Affair's a yearner, isn't it?
Yeah. You can't... It's also a Christmas song.
Is it?
Yeah.
Come on, let's have a sing and dance.
Millie and Yaz, who are two fans of the Madlands music scene.
The biggest Madlands fans you've ever made.
You guys create the stage invasions.
We do. We know like the songs that are perfect for it. And
Yeah, basically it's just Joy Affair every time.
Yeah,
it's a banger, you know?
God bless Russ, Sugar Thief's dad. He literally, every time there's a stage invasion, he runs to the front and is like, right, I'm going to make sure this is safe. as safe as it can possibly be. Do you guys think that Birmingham's music scene is like unparalleled in that like underground kind of madness? Because I go to lots of other gigs at this level and there's nothing that matches it.
Our group of friends, like, we're literally from completely different cities. That's the thing, like some of them are from Carve. Like, he's George from like Birkswell or something, loads of people from
Birkswell. No way. Shout out Birkswell. Good church.
Like, literally, none of us would have met if we hadn't been like part
Hello. Of this is really hurting my arm. I'm into being fans. It's George Pennell.
Yeah.
That really hurt my hand.
I said how we met like that.
George met
It's a big group of friends. I'd love. Friends!
This is, wait, what's your name? I haven't met
We're
him
meeting
before,
friends.
But now,
it's happening. You could be best friends in the future.
Madeline's reunites
big friends.
It does. And it creates friendships. Madeline's slogan. We'll get it on printed on t-shirts. Do you want to sign out the vlog? Because my arm really hurts.
Join us next time for the second episode of the Madeline's interview.
Oh, Madeline!
It's George Bennett. Fuck, man. How's the bromance with Liam Deacon going?
Yeah, something. Yeah. confusion. It's really good, actually. Really good.
Do you secretly just want to join the claws?
Careful.
Careful.
No.